Welcome students, this is the 20th lecture on digital land surveying and mapping. Today I am going to discuss about the propagation of errors and specification of survey measurements. Now in the last class we have discussed that whenever we take measurements, specifically it is found, it can be seen, it can be observed when we take a set of observations or a observation repeated times, the measurements we find are not equal. That itself indicates that the measurements or observations we are taking for the parameter are associated with errors. Now as the quality of surveying work depends upon the quality of the measurement, so we need to remove or minimize the errors. And in the last class we have found that standard error is an indicator which provides us about the quality of the measurement. Now in surveying we go for some primary measurement, and from those measurements we do derive some data. If we want to find out the distance between two points, in case of plane surveying it is the horizontal distance. Using total estimation we get the slope distance, and from slope distance and vertical angle we get the horizontal distance. So horizontal distance is a derived quantity from slope distance and vertical angle. So like that, many other parameters or quantities of surveying is derived from fundamental measurements. And if the measurements are associated with some error, while we will be computing or deriving the other parameters, then those error due to those measurements also will propagate to the derived quantity. Now today's class we will like to discuss how these error gets propagated, and finally how we do find out the precision of the derived parameter. And followed by, whenever we go for surveying we need to maintain the quality of the surveying. So how do you maintain the quality? For that we need to specify some requirements, that is called specification for the survey work, that we need to know what should be the specification of any survey work. So today I will discuss these two points, and these will be taught under the following head, that how the standard error, which is an indicator of quality of measurement, gets propagated. Then how this standard error get propagated in horizontal distance measurement or horizontal distance computation, leveling work, trigonometrical leveling, in finding out the location, and survey specification. So error from individual measurements propagates to derived quantities. In order to determine the precision of the computed parameters, it is required to understand how errors get propagated from measurements to computation of parameters. Since original measurements contain errors in random in nature or randomly distributed errors, so also we assume that the derived quantity will also contain the errors in randomly distributed. That means random distribution means we will make use of the concept of normal distribution, which we have discussed in the last class. Now we know that the standard error SX is the indicator of the quality of measurement. So we would like to know how the standard error gets propagated to the derived quantity. Suppose a quantity Q, let us consider a quantity Q which is derived out of measurements M1, M2, M3 up to MN. That means N parameter, it is a quantity derived from N independent parameters. So I can write the quantity Q as an X. Like for example, the horizontal distance we do get from the slope distance and the vertical angle. So I can say it is a function of L and alpha. Actually it is, we know that horizontal distance is equal to S cos alpha, So which is a function of L and alpha, or the vertical distance is equal to L sin alpha. So it is a function of again L and alpha, but this is a another function f1, so a different function. Similar to that, let us generalize this through like a quantity q, which is a function of measurements m1, m2, m2. Then what will be the standard error of the parameter x is equal to the what is the standard error. So there is a law, general law of propagation of error, which states that the standard error of the derived parameter will be equal to the partial derivative of the with respect to the first parameter square, and the standard error of the first parameter like this. So we can get this. Now with this background, I like to go for so propagation of error in engineering survey parameters. Now in engineering survey, generally we have the fundamental quantity. In plane surveying, we do may go for measurement of using total station, we go for measurement of slope distance and vertical angle and say horizontal angle. These are the parameters we measure. This is the measured parameters. And from there we do get horizontal distance, vertical distance, that means horizontal distance, and also we need to have the location. So horizontal distance is L cosine of alpha and vertical distance is L sin alpha. Now suppose I have a terrain like this. This is the station A and this is the station B. Now if I have a station, total station here, I have a reflector here, so I have the slope distance L and the vertical angle alpha. And if we see from top, then our AB must be along some line AB, and suppose this is the reference direction, so this is our horizontal angle theta. So this is the horizontal distance, and vertical distance will be V, and this is H, and this is H. So if we know the if we want to know the coordinate location of B, so we can get it from H cos theta is the, if it is our east direction, north direction, and it is our east direction, generally local coordinates are in north and east. So S cos theta is the north and H sin theta is the east. So in this way you can see that location is a function of, now H is a function of L cosine of alpha and then cosine of theta, and L cosine of alpha and sin theta. So location of B is a function of L theta alpha. This is the our measured parameter, and these are the derived parameter. Now we will like to, I will like first to say how this either horizontal or vertical distance, it will be of similar nature. So how the, what will be the standard error in horizontal distance measurement? So it will be equal to dH by dL whole square than S L square plus dH by TL whole square into S alpha square. For H cos alpha, we can get this thing. So now dH by dL means derivative of L H with respect to L, this is equal to cos square alpha, cos alpha. So this is cos alpha and squaring is cos square alpha is L square alpha, and dH by d L and this is dH by d alpha, this will be alpha. dH by d alpha will be equal to L sin alpha. So L square sin square alpha is alpha square. So you can see now if we know the angle alpha and the slope distance L, as well as the standard error of the slope length, standard error of the particle angle, then we will be able to compute the standard error of the measurement in height. So this is the way how we can find out the standard error of our derived quantity. Similar way we can do also for vertical distance, only sine will be cosine, cosine will be sine. Now then another important thing which we do in case of surveying is that leveling. Now in case of leveling, suppose I want to find out the difference in level between two stations A and B. What is the difference in level? So generally what we do, we set up our instrument somewhere in between, and preferably the distance, horizontal distance between these two anyway. So suppose we want to find out the difference in elevation between A and B. So we have set up the instrument here, level instrument here, and we take our staff reading here. So this is the staff reading we have taken, and this is called back sight. So first sight taken after setting up the instrument is called back sight. So suppose we got a reading RB, and then we are taking a reading with the staff held at B, which is the foresight, and RF is the staff reading. So the difference in level between A and B will be equal to RB minus RF. So this is a very simple, already all of us we know the difference in level between, let me write del H to now the what will be the standard error in measurement of difference in height. So S del H square will be equal to, now if we take the first derivative here, so it will be 1, so it will be S R B square plus S F square. Now whether it is positive or negative, one thing has to be marked, always we take this in this way R F, the we do take the this as like this, and the standard error for RB or minus of RB will be same, only it is opposite side. So we do take this as a positive and we get this thing. So the standard error of the difference in height will be the sum of the standard error of the two measurements that is involved in this, which are related by a addition operator. Now if we consider that SL is the standard error in millimeter per unit of length of sight, let us say this is the standard error generally in case of an instrument, the standard error in measurement of height is given in terms of in this way. Standard error in the measurement of level means height is in millimeter with respect to per meter length of sight. So if we assume that this backside distance and the foreside distance are equal, then these two error will be same as well as, so I can write it 2 s l d. So 2 s l d, and then it will be squaring of this. So this is SB or SF will be equal to SD into SL into D. So it will be squaring this as this. Error will be like this. Now if these instead of having only one setup, sometimes when the benchmark has to be taken far off, then we will be need to go for n numbers of setup. Now let us consider, so when there will be n numbers of setup, then there will be n numbers of difference in height. So the total height difference del h will be equal to del h1, del h2, like that, del hn. Now so the error associated with del h will be equal to del h square will be equal to error associated with del h1, error associated with the del h2, like that, hn square. Now since this we have considered, if we say that all these back sides and fore sides are equal, then all these value will be equal, then we can write it will be n standard error of any one of this and this. So now already we have known that del h square is equal to 2 d square s del h square. This is already we have derived. So we can substitute the same thing here, then we will get. Now one more thing, if the total distance is d, then our total distance is 2 into n into d. So because there are back side and fore side, so these 2 will come. So our total distance, if the distance is d actually, then it will be 2 n d. So from here we can substitute n equal to d by 2 d. So if we substitute this n equal to d by 2 d and s equal to 2 d square s del h square, so from here we can get this square this and d d s del h square. So the standard error for the height will be equal to plus minus standard error of the single measurement square root of d into d. So this is the standard error for taking the finding out the difference in level between two stations having distance d, which is observed by taking a or setting up the instrument at an interval of distance d. So the backside, the d is the distance for backside and foreside for each setup of the instrument, and it is considered to be equal for all setup. So in that, under that condition, we will be able to get the error in measurement in height, the standard error in measurement of height will be equal to this. So in this way we can compute the error associated with the difference in level. Now the next, another important thing which we do go for in measurement of height, where specifically when we go for measurement with using total station, another thing we do in case of total station, we do measurement, we do measure the height difference by trigonometrical leveling. Now what is that? Already we have discussed, suppose A and B are the two stations whose difference in elevation we want to find out. So or we want to find out the height of B. What is the height of B? And height of A is known. So what do? We do set up the instrument here and we do help the reflector and we do take our observation to this reflector and we get the slope length and vertical angle. Now also we do take the height of the instrument and also we know what is the height of the reflector, height of the reflector. So to find out the height of B can be found out from height of A plus height of the instrument plus L sin alpha minus height of the reflector. So this is the way how we do measure the now what will be the standard error in height of B? That will be height of B will be equal to the height of height of A, this is A, then height of standard error of the height of A, because it is one unit, so standard error of the height of instrument minus standard error plus standard error height of the reflector plus for this sin square alpha and then this one and then L square cosine square alpha square. So this is the I have derived it directly from the law of propagation. Similarly also we can do the propagation of error while we will be finding out the location of any point. So already I had given you the details how to find out the location and we can do it. So with this I like to go for next point, the survey specification, because we want to maintain the quality of surveying work. So whenever we want to maintain the quality of surveying work, we should go for some specified specification according to which we should carry out surveying work. Specification has to be defined with respect to some indicator. So we do make use of permitted deviation, permitted deviation as the indicator for quality of surveying or the as an indicator for specifying the specification of surveying. Now what is permitted deviation? It is considered to be 2.5 times the standard error. So already we know what is standard error, how to find out the standard error for defined for basic measurements as well as from divided parameter. So on the basis of the standard error, if we multiply it by 2.5, that will be the value of the permitted deviation, and depending upon the permitted deviation value we have to specify what should be the requirement for particular specification. Now we know that the standard error means that the parameter is 68%. Since 68%, if we say that the standard error, if we remember the normal curve, so when mu plus sigma, mu minus sigma, this is the mu, this is the sigma or the Sx. So this is, that means if any measurement falls within this, then the chance of that measurement having the true value is 68%. So that is the way how you do define the 68% probability. And so our standard error should be less than whatever parameter deviation will be defined given divided by 2.5. So standard error of our measurement or the derived quantity should be less than this, and now this will depend upon the specification that has been given to you for meeting to particular quality. Now there are many specifications available, and these specifications are actually based on the type of control network on which it falls, control network or control. So before we, there are three types of control generally we go for in carrying out the surveying. One is called primary control, secondary control and tertiary control. Primary controls are the most stringent one, and it is very rarely available. However, to have our work in case of a very big construction work or project, at least we need to have one primary control point. Now secondary control point actually are based on primary control point, and secondary control points are primarily used for setting out works, and within the secondary control point, tertiary control points are established. As I had discussed in the first few classes, that the principle of working of surveying is to work from whole to part. So first we have to establish the primary control point. Within that primary control point, we should go for secondary control point, which should take primary control point as the basis, and we should fit it, and within the primary control, secondary control point, tertiary control points again come up. And tertiary control points are basically used for collecting the our further data. So tertiary control point actually really serves the purpose for collecting the data, and secondary control points are used for setting out work. Now the we should go for some specification, and there are many specifications available. It varies from place to place, country to country, and from work to work. One of the specification now I have shown you here just as an indicative. This is the specification that Institution of Civil Engineering Surveyors adopted. So you can see primary control point having the first order and second order, then the distance, angle and height. These are the three primary measurement parameters which we need to have, or we generally we should get, and from there we can derive the derived quantities. So these are the specification that has been defined, and you can see here these values where first order primary control point, then distance should be having a standard error 0.5 square root of L, when a this whole of this is in millimeter but L is in meter. So this is the criteria which is to satisfy when we should go for primary first order distance measurement. Primary first order angle measurement should satisfy this thing, and primary first order height measurement should satisfy this thing if the distance between two points is 250 meter. So in that way there are different specifications given, which has to be satisfied, and or on the other way, depending upon what value it achieved, we can say that is the quality of the survey. So with this, I like to conclude, summarize today's class. Precision of most surveys can be determined by analyzing the way in which error propagates through them. From the standard error of the primary measurements, we can find out the standard error or precision of the computed value. So for all types of survey, precision of outcomes should be done. Now, while we will be going for computation of propagation of errors, if there is some involvement of measurement angle measured, then those angles has to be converted to radians. This is one thing which we have to be careful, that degrees should be converted to radian. Now all of we know that 2 pi equal to 360 degree. So 360 degree equal to 2 pi. From there we can convert any number of degree, minute, second to radian. So that is, and for quality control, surveying work should follow standard specifications, and specific standard may be related to surveying measurements as well as work. So tertiary specifications, as I show, it is based on work. So with this, I like to conclude today's class, and next class I will go for another topic of this, that is the mapping part. So first we have discussed the surveying control point establishment, then we have discussed the total station, which we generally go for collection of field data, and now that measurement part is over, now we will go for mapping fundamentals. We will learn how the mapping work has to be done, what are the different considerations to be taken to make use of the measurements to convert to survey map. Thank you.